Thank you, Jesus. Just begin to thank the Lord right now. Begin to thank him. Begin to give him all the praise. Begin to adore his name. Our God deserves praise. Continue to thank him. Begin to thank the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Begin to thank the Lord right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, receive your praise, receive your honor. Ancient of days, as old as you are, as old as you are, you will never change. Ancient of days, thank you, Jesus. As old as you are, I want you to wave your hands unto him right now. As old as you are, you will never change. Are you here this morning? Ancient of days, as old as you are, as old as you are, you will never change. As old as you are, as old as you are, you will never change. A scent of days, as old as you are, as old as you are, you will never change. Ancient of days, as old as you are, yes, Lord, as old as you are, as old as you are, Jesus, you never change. Ancient of days, as old as you are, everybody shout hallelujah. May you be seated in Jesus' name. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Do you have your Bible, church? If you have your Bible, lift your Bible up. Thank you, Jesus. I want to see your Bible. Shout amen. Thank you, Jesus. Say, dear Lord, you are my Father. Daddy, I respect you. And this is your book. Lord Jesus, I will continue to read this book in your name, Jesus. Amen. Kiss your Bible. Do you love your Bible? Shout hallelujah. This is the word of God. Everything that you want to get or you want to see, church, is in this book. A book that contains wisdom. Shout hallelujah. Continue to read your Bible every day in and day out. Shout amen. When you are going to work, you can put the little one, am I right? Lunchtime, read it. Shout hallelujah. If you want to go to bed, you have to what? Read it. May the good Lord be with you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Do I have somebody here today who wants to receive favor? The word called favor. I don't know. If you don't want favor, please lift your hands up and let me. The way somebody say, hey, everybody shout hallelujah. Who wants favor? You need a favor. Shout hallelujah. Let me tell you this. You have to work before you will get what? Paid. Shout hallelujah. Am I right? Am I right? You have to work before you get paid. And if you don't have, let's say it right now, a job, and every month you get what? Paid. Somebody say, Father, I receive it. You receive it? Are you sure? Are you tired about working? 4 a.m. Look at her. Shout hallelujah. Let me tell you this. Listen to me. By the time I finish this sermon, church, you will go home with the word called favor. Oh, I didn't hear amen. I didn't hear amen. Let me tell you this. Let me tell you this. Anytime a prophet mans the pulpit, he's preaching, not finish preaching and begin to prophesy and do something. His preaching is purely prophetic. Listen to me. You have to tap into it. Shout hallelujah. You have to what? Tap into it. It's a prophetic word. And what is the meaning of amen? It means that let it be what? I declare unto somebody this morning that you will depart from this place with a word called favor. I didn't hear amen. I didn't hear amen. Shout hallelujah. May you be seated in Jesus' name. Shout amen. Amen. Can I tell you something? The junior brother of our favor is jealousy. I want you to write it down. The junior what? Of what? Is what? Jealousy. Not the senior brother. Junior. No, the junior. Shout hallelujah. Jealousy is next to who? The word called favor. I'm coming. Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that? When God released favor upon your life, listen to me, you will face two groups of people. Other ones will be happy with you
but the rest, they will jealous you. The reason is that, listen to me, the reason is that they will sit down and check one or two things and say that, this man doesn't forfeit in that area. This woman has no university, what did they call it? Doctorate degree, am I right? But how come this woman is moving in the higher dimension? They will not understand. But until they begin to know that there is a word called favor, church, they'll begin to talk and move up and down. But I am here to reveal unto you today that anytime favor comes upon your life, you must be ready also about the word called jealousy. Shout amen. Amen. Favor is something that your strength cannot what? Do. But the God himself will just give it to you. Favor is something that you yourself, you know that you cannot even reach to that level, but God himself will take you there. Favor is something that you can get some good job whereby you know that you yourself.
God bless you. Everybody shout hallelujah. It is the word called favor. Everybody shout hallelujah. And let me tell you this. Those that will be happy with you, they will sit down and think about spiritual things. But anybody that will use physical what? Mind. And to understand the word called favor or the favor that is upon your life, church, they will not understand.
Moses received favor from the Lord. God gave him favor.
Shout hallelujah. I'm about to prove something unto you.
A man that called Moses that said to God that, Father, you know that I'm a stammerer, that I can't speak well.
But the Lord said, Moses, whether you like it or not, you will do that job. Shout amen. Shout hallelujah.
And God gave this man favor.
And he started his work. The book of Exodus chapter 33. Do you have your Bible? Exodus what? 33. Shout amen. I think we have it in the Bible. 33. Am I right? Can you see? Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Spirit of the Living God. Leba hakasaka. Exodus what? 33. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Lord, I thank you. And verse number 12 coming. Do you have 12? Can you see it? Can I read? Okay, look at this.
Moses said to the Lord, you have been telling me, lead this people. But you have not let me know whom you will send with me.
Can you see?
You have said, I know you by name.
I want you to underline. I'm reading from the NIV.
I know you by what?
By name.
Listen to me. By the time I finish this, the Lord is going to call you by your name.
Everybody shout hallelujah. Let me tell you this. I am Kwajo, Monday morning. I don't know about you. Maybe a queer Wednesday. Or in Sierra Leone. Or maybe Cameroon. You guys have the same thing. Am I right? Monday morning and something. Yeah, Ghana. Kojo Akuya Nanaya, you know, Monday morning, Kojo Ajua, you know, a lady, Adua, so and so. Shout hallelujah. Listen to me. Listen to me. Kojo.
It's that Monday. That what? Monday. That gave me that name what?
Kojo.
Am I right? But my real name is not my father who gave it to me. Neither my mother. But it's God.
Then somebody says that it's God. Ah, your dad used to call Mr. Dwomoh Sarpong. That's why you are Dwomoh Sarpong. What are you talking about? Listen to me.
Everybody sitting here today, I want you to understand this. You have a spiritual name. A name God himself gave it to you before you came on this earth. Shout hallelujah. And until you identify that spiritual name, church, things will not be what? Will not be right. But today, by the hand of Jehovah, you are going to identify that spiritual name. The name God gave you the time that you were in the womb of your what? Of your mother. Then somebody will say that, what is that name? Can you tell me? Listen to me. That name can be success. That name can be favor. That name can be called Sister Mercy. That name, you can name it. It means that before you were formed, God has already designed you and God has already released a powerful name upon you. And listen to me. And that name is your physical tag. It's your physical what? Tag. When you go to store, and if you want something, you will check it. Am I right? At times you can see some guys with jacket. Am I right? And you will still see the tag. Am I right? Moving around. Do you want somebody to see? Excuse me, I beg you. You have to take it out. You are not from the village. Everybody shout hallelujah. And you'll be preaching and you'll be showing off. This is Kenneth Cole. Which Kenneth Cole? You have to take it off. Shout hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I talking to someone? Or somebody will put a nice jacket with a bow tie and at the same time you will see a necklace, a chain. Gold one, 1, 2, 3. Please, I beg you, take it out. Everybody shout hallelujah. We are not going to fountain, what did they call it? Fountain dress or something. Am I speaking to somebody? Let me tell you this. God has already released a tag on your forehead. You have a tag. Wait and I'm coming. Listen. You can have this jacket and somebody can have the same thing and this one can have another one, but the prices will be what? To be different. Am I right? Some will be $11.99. Some will be $79.99. Some will be $300. Some will be $1,000. Shout hallelujah. You can name it. Why other ones will be more costly than what? The other. Why? Why? Because of the what? Because of the what? Because of the what? Because of the what? Let me tell you this. You are not going to receive just a tag. You are going to receive a powerful tag that will sell more than others. And that tag is on your forehead. Everybody shout hallelujah. I say, and that tag is on your what? On your forehead. Every man of God, every pastor, every member, everybody shout hallelujah. That is why when you become a man of God, I'm not saying that you have to lift your shoulders up. No, you have to be humble. I beg you in the name of God. But you have to move from the level whereby some people will come to you and give you $20 and 50-50. Oh, may the Lord be with you. Pastor Chris doesn't deserve $20. Neither 50. Shout hallelujah. And I don't deserve $5,000. I deserve more than that. Because I am more costly than gold. So when you are coming to me with $100, excuse me, which may the Lord, good Lord, bless you. That is your strength. Am I right? Recently, one of my daughters, a woman, she gave me $100. I said, Lord, may you bless this. Do you know the reason why? Because that was her strength. You have to appreciate it. Am I right? But some people have more than that. Millions upon millions. They will go and take the little one and say, the man of God, you take this. It's an insult to God. So you men of God, $50, $20, God bless you. Can I have $20 to buy gas? Stop! Never beg any church member. Never. Because the day you will beg a church member to get what? Money to buy your gas. That will be the day. You will lose what? Respect. Never. Even if you are dying, you have to depend on that God who has called you. Everybody shout hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I talking to somebody? So when you are bringing some things on your table, please think before you bring it. And bring something special. Something that will touch the heart of Pastor Krish. Say that may the good Lord bless you. Not only him, Abdul, everyone. Shout hallelujah. And when you are coming to me over robots, think about it. So when you give Pastor Chris 1,000, you have to bring what? 10,000 on my table. Everybody shout hallelujah. Polite, do you understand? You are a millionaire. Bring 10,000 on my table and let me bless you. Everybody shout hallelujah. We have so many believers, they are afraid of 10,000. The question right now is, what is 10,000? Church, I don't, listen to me. Glory be to God. You know, I don't like show off and some things. No, glory be to God. But 10,000 is nothing if you want to give it to a man of God. I don't know if it's my level. I have above those things. People can put 40,000 on my table. Not in America, in Africa. Not in America, in Africa. Everybody shout hallelujah. A land that worth over $100,000, a king will call me and say that, take it. Everybody, and I have them. I didn't sell them, I have them. I kept it. If I want to sell those lands, church, it will be more than $2 million. Starting from at the age of 28. So when you are bringing some... I'm ready. When you are bringing something on somebody's table, like this man of God or a woman of God, Pastor Vivian, please, I beg you in the name of God. Oh, man of God. May the good Lord be with you. Yes, listen. You don't have. That is your strength. Oh, church, you know if I have God, I will give more than that. Pastor Chris, get this 200. God knows your heart. Shout hallelujah. But you can reach to some certain level, church, whereby you know that you have more than that. And you look into your money and take the little one. It's God that deserves the little. Please, I beg you. A whole year, God has been faithful to you. A whole year, nothing evil didn't what happened to you. A whole year. You have to appreciate your leaders. When I ask you a question right now that this Christmas, do you have someone, did the pastor, that somebody knock your door and drop something on your table? Man of God? Yes. How many members?
Few of them.
And you kept quiet. Buying suit and jackets. Everybody shout hallelujah. Be on your feet. And let me. How many? 20 or 40? Look at his tie. Everybody shout hallelujah. Did they get someone? And you two, you kept, so quiet. Then let me stop talking.
Peter, you too? Ah, look at this, quiet. Pastor Samson, you too? Nothing. Pastor Samson, nothing. I will see you, okay? Everybody shout hallelujah. Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, starting from today, you must change your perception. Everybody shout hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, you must change your perception. Am I speaking to somebody? Because when we talk about the name tag, church, every good man of God is costly more than gold. I'm talking about every good what? Good man of God. And I am one of them. Oh, I didn't hear amen. Look at somebody and say, you are one of them. Look at this. You can't even say it. Everybody shout hallelujah. Everybody shout hallelujah. Let me tell you this. After this preaching, you will not pray for favor, but favor will knock your door. After this preaching, favor will sit by your side when you are going to work. After this preaching, favor, excuse me, with due respect, when you are in your washroom, favor will stand by you. After this prayer, even after this preaching, when you cough, it will be favor. After this preaching, when you dance, it will be favor. After this preaching, church, when you shout, it will be favor. After this preaching, when your children go to school, it will be favor. After this preaching, everything that you will do, it will turn into favor. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, your hour has come. And for you to receive favor. If you believe that, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Oh, I didn't hear amen. I didn't hear amen. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I talking to someone? Church. Susan. God bless you. God bless you. Everybody shout hallelujah. Listen to me. May the Lord today give you ability to control. Oh, I didn't hear amen. Ability to what? To control. Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that? Some of you, when God drop $1 million by your door, you collapse. You end up in the which hospital? Prince George's. Am I right? Emergency. They have to call Prophet Frank for me to come over there with anointing oil. And you say that, where am I, Prophet? I can't see it. Just come on $1 million. I say, come on what? $1 million. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Am I talking to someone? Am I speaking to somebody? When the favor comes upon your life, you will not ask people, but people will ask you. Listen, they will beg you and to give to you. Others will be begging, but you will not beg. But people will be begging you and say that, please, we beg you, can you take it? That is the word called favor. Everybody shout hallelujah. Everybody shout glory be to God. Once upon a time, a certain king in back home, which I prayed for, the man used to work in a liquor store. And I prayed for that man. I said that you are going to be a king in future. You are nobody, but that's here the Lord. Church. That his uncle, excuse me, please, pass away, die. Then they were looking for somebody who has to be a king, you know, started. Oh, let's call this, let's call that. The man came to me, I said, hey, Nana. He said, oh, Odifo, you are calling me Nana. It means a prophet, you're calling me Nana. I'm not Nana now. I say, you'll be what? Very soon, you shall be called Nana. You mark it. Shout hallelujah. They started doing their incantations, you know, the kinship something, you know, and the whole thing, consulted their gods. And their gods mention the name of that man, which I don't want to mention the name of that one. Came to me and said, Prophet, the girls, they have already chosen him. I said, no, it's not those girls. God has already mentioned your name. And listen to me. And because of the favor, God mentioned the man's name and the girls confirmed. I didn't hear amen. When you receive favor from God, witches, even they will confirm and say that this one has already been blessed. Do you know the reason? Because they will not have any choice than to confirm. And today, you and I, we are going to receive confirmation about this favor from witches and wizards. Somebody said that, Prophet, what are you talking about? Yes, when God favored you, witches will not have any choice. When God favored you, then Mami Wata will not have any choice. When God favored you, those wizards will not have any choice than to accept it. Because the one who has been approved by God, nobody can never disapprove that person. That is called favor. When God gives you mighty approval, church, who can disapprove you? That is called favor. Everybody shout hallelujah. Moses, whether you like it or not, you are the one that will do that work. So the king came to me, Prophet, you thank God. I said, Nana, kneel down, let me pray for you. Because you have no choice. Which, if you want to go before king, those who are from, you know, back home, Ghana, they know, I think everywhere, you have to bow. Am I right? You have to put your clothes somewhere and bow. King, shout hallelujah. But I did not. I told him to bow and wait for me. Shout hallelujah. I went into my room. Picked my anointing oil, came back, and he was still kneeling down. That is called anointing and the favor. Shout hallelujah. I poured the oil on him. He started shaking his head. Amen. Amen. Oh, amen. Oh. As according to the word of God, so shall he be. Go and everything will be done. Banana, be very careful. Be very careful about women. Be very careful. That when you get money, when you begin to sell some of the lands, you will use some to do some powerful things for your own what? Community, your village. You say, Prophet, thank you very much. Shout hallelujah. I went there, saw him with, those gold thing and the whole thing. And at that time, I have to show some kind of, I said, Nana, I greet you. Oh, Osofu, you are bowing before me. No, you don't have to do. I said, Nana, I have to do. Shout hallelujah. Ah, I was in my place. He came. Papa, who is this? Prophet, it's me. I came to thank you. Shout hallelujah. I said, Nana, Nida, let me pray for you again. I gave him some certain directions. Shout hallelujah. Osofo, you hear from me. I said, Nana, no problem. Shout glory be to God. I was in my house. Come and see lands upon lands. Do you need one? Unless you come to Ghana. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. I won't mention the numbers. Shout amen. And I told him that, Nana, I have my in-law, my brother-in-law. He is in Amsterdam, Holland. I need something for him. Oh, so how many? I said, I need 2 plots of land. Oh, man of God, you know, it's this amount. But please, bring one half. I said, Nana, half, I won't pay. He said, please, take something out and bring anything that you want to. Shout hallelujah. And at that time, my brother-in-law, the one who is next to Pastor Vivian, Richard, somebody has already chopped his money. Let me use that word. His money. Give the money to somebody. The person says, I will buy you a land. I will build a house and the whole thing. Tell the person, stop the money and the whole thing. So the guy had, you know, started weeping. Oh, look at this. Amsterdam, sister. I don't know. I was lying down and I heard my brother-in-law crying, weeping. Sister, look at this. All these years, I've been in Holland for 10 years. I asked my wife, I said, what's going on? He said, Richard, somebody, I said, tell Richard that I need, I think at that time, 2,000 or something to do something. My wife said, ah, wait. I said, tell him. I said, give me the phone. I said, Richard, how are you? Can I have $2,000? I need it. I want to use it to buy my ticket. He said, oh, you know, somebody just duped me and how can I? I said, please. The guy sent the money, and I went to the king, gave the king, I think, 1,000 or 800. At that time, I said, I need 2+ of land. He said, yes, sir. Hey, Kofi, Kwame, go and show us off for that land. I said, okay, God bless you. Please, I want you to clear the land, everything. And I used my brother-in-law's 1,000, and I put something, added something to his money, and I started his foundation. Some things, 2+, with pictures and everything. I was going to Canada and I took a KLM. So when I arrived in Amsterdam, I told my brother, I said, come, I want to see you. I said, come, I want to come and let's talk. So he came. I said, take this. You have 2+ of lands. This is your foundation. And he said, not, I don't know whether they're under the power of God or his own power or something. Shout out. But this one, let me use his own power. Church, busted into tears. Oh, what's awful? Oh, Akontapa. Good in-law. Oh, good in-law. Good in-law. I said, I didn't need your 2,000. I wanted to, I added something to it. Shout out. And now he has that building and another plus. Very powerful place. Shout hallelujah. So let me tell you this. When God gives you favor, those who are with you will enjoy. Oh, I didn't hear amen. So when God gives you favor, even your pet, your dog, your cat, they will enjoy. Do you know the reason why? The reason why your cat and your dog, they will enjoy is that you will have surpluses of food. Shout hallelujah. But if you don't have favor from God and you yourself, you are hungry, how can you give your dogs food? Today, may this favor that is coming upon your life, church, change your entire life. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. And I'm telling you, by the hand of Jehovah, your life will never be the same. Receive the favor. I said, receive the favor. And let me tell this, because of the favor, your sisters will enjoy, your brothers will enjoy, your wife will enjoy, your husband will enjoy, your cousins, they will enjoy, your friends will enjoy. May the favor of God come upon your life. I didn't hear amen. May you make a joyful noise unto them. Look unto somebody and say, I am ready today to receive the favor. Do you know the reason why the Lord gave Moses favor? Church, if you want to talk about somebody who has to be a leader, I can tell you that Moses, there is no way that man can be. Why? Because the man was what? Couldn't talk well. And listen to me. For somebody to go before the king and talk to the king, it has to be somebody who is what? Eloquent. Wonderful person. Somebody who can talk good. Somebody who can influence and affluence. Somebody who can establish.
Somebody who can talk to somebody. That is why Moses said that, you know me. There is no way I can talk to the king. Go to the palace and learn some certain things and you will know. Those who speak for the king, church, they know how to talk. It means that they have sharp mouth. The way they talk, there will be no mistake. When you bring any kind of words, they can shout you and say, hey, keep your mouth. You can't talk like that. You are before the king. Am I speaking to somebody? But the Lord said, Moses, whether you want to go or not, you have already found favor. You will do it. Church, when the favor of God comes upon your life, even with your own mistakes, people will clap for you. That is called favor. Shout hallelujah. Can I tell you something? And when the favor of God comes upon your life, church, you have to make good use of that favor. Don't joke with it and sit down and say that, oh Lord, I know that I have the favor. You will continue to do it. Don't be stupid. I beg you in the name of God. Make good use of that favor. Not duped people. The things that you haven't seen, you will tell the people that I've been seeing some things on top of your head. Come and pay $1,000. No, we don't do those things here. Am I right? Oh, I've seen something. Let me send somebody to mountains and pray for you. And while I was speaking into the realms of the spirit, I saw number 5 and I saw 0. Another 0. Another 0. And the angel of the Lord said unto me, it's 5,000. You know, you know already. Don't cause any spiritual thing to do people. And because of that, God, I don't know if you have it. God wants you to put 5,000. I'm telling you, in the name of Elohim, heaven will speak. Whereby you haven't seen anything. When you do that, God will punish you. Don't take advantage, people. Shout amen. Do your work. Do what you want to do. At the right time, your God will visit you. But do you know the reason why these days some men of God, they charge people? Because the members, they have become stingy. I'm telling you. Some men of God, they have been sitting down, you know, all these years, you know, I don't have anything to show off. It is time for me to. And they'll begin to chat people. Shout amen. And these days, if you don't change your voice, I can see something. And I saw spiritual dove moving into the atmosphere. It was 7 tentacles. Move on to the higher dove. People will not give you something. That is why the members do they want. Be simple and know that my God has already called me and God wants me to help his work. My God wants me to sponsor the ministry. My God wants me to do this. Shout hallelujah. Do it. And when you do it, your God will bless you. Everybody shout hallelujah. You have to know that my pastor is a Levite. Spiritual and the physical, am I right? And Levi, the word of the Moses said that the Levi, they should not what? Work. Shout hallelujah. It's their brothers that have to work and feed them. So every pastor is a Levite. So it's the members that have to do something for the pastor. But if the members are not doing it, what is going to happen? When your pastor mans the pulpit, will talk nonsense. He's anointed, all right. Shout hallelujah. But because of the hunger, shout amen. So one time, Archbishop Uzzah said that anointing without money is annoyance. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout amen. When the fire is burning in your bones, and if you want to go out there, you'll be annoying. Shout amen.
And the things that you don't even have to shout, you will shout. Am I right? Some members will come to, instead of you to lay your hands, you know, in a diplomatic way, in the name of Hammer, Holy Ghost, you think it's anointed, your pastor is frustrated. Everybody shout hallelujah. So look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, starting from today, the word called favor will accompany you. But please, make good use of the favor. Shout amen. Shout hallelujah. Please, we must learn how to appreciate. I said we must learn how to what? Learn how to appreciate. Shout hallelujah. We must learn how to what? Appreciate. There was a time, you know, Pastor C started talking to some people. Prophet wants this, you know, and about a car. Shout amen. Some people, they started giving some things, and you didn't see any car. Do you know the reason why? The reason is that the money they gave was too little that cannot buy the car. Shout hallelujah. Whereby one person can stand. Pastor Rick, be on your feet. Pastor Rick came to me on, was it Friday? Friday. The prophet, you know, you prophesied to me about, but when we will talk, I will talk to you and your wife. And that God is going to do some things in my life. You know, our branch in Delaware, a lady sent some things onto me. I opened it. It was a check of $10,000 and said that I should use it. I heard somebody say, so you guys, what is 10,000 that you are saying is? This is just the beginning. It's nothing. It's nothing. Send a 10,000 and say that you must go and look for a car in the whole thing. Just one person. God bless you. Shout hallelujah. Amen. Gave, because a prophetic word came. Came to me and confirmed. I said, it was late. I said, let's meet today. Shout hallelujah. Church, you can do it. You can what? You can do it. There was a time, back home, can I tell you this? Listen to me. At times, you may not have it, but you have to force yourself to do. You will not understand. When you reach to that level, you will understand. When you get there, I'm not telling you that, please, force yourself to do something. No. Somebody will say, how can I do it? I did it. I said, I did what? I did it. I came home, told Pastor Vivian, it's okay. If God Almighty is the one who spoke to you, I am behind you. Shout hallelujah. Church, it was over $22,000. Not cedis, $1,000. In those days, not these days. The money that I have to use to do something, the whole thing, Holy Ghost spoke to me, said, go and do it. It will sound what? Crazy. Excuse me. But the Lord said, you too, I will do something that you will not understand. And I won't tell you. The Lord did it. Everybody shout hallelujah. I said, the Lord what? The Lord did it. Oh, I don't have more. Oh, this church. A lady, 10,000 pastor, used it to look for a car. A prophetic word came, and God touched someone. Everybody shout hallelujah. One time, just one person was talking to Eric, and say that, man of God, I'm going through some things. Tell the prophet, if you guys can pray for me and the whole thing, I will, me alone. And the husband, am I right? She said, she alone, am I right? They will buy a land for the church. Shout amen. If one person wants to buy a land for the church, you can have a covenant with God. We all have covenant with him. That is called salvation covenant. But there is difference between salvation covenant and a covenant of what? Blessings. Giving. Giving covenant. Because of the blood of Jesus, we have covenant with him. You are a child of God. But if you don't take care and put some things in place, you can serve God in poverty and die and go to heaven good. You can serve God in what? Poverty. And go to heaven good. And that is not the will of God. Amen. The Lord wants you to serve him and to enjoy the good things of the land. And also enjoy in heaven. And also enjoy in what? So if you want to live in poverty and die and go to heaven good, may the Lord be with you. But me and my household, in Banu. Hey! When you live poor, on this earth, when you go to heaven, how can you walk on the gold? Shout hallelujah. You must have servants. You must have male servants. People must come to you and feel good. That shows that you have found favor before God. When you do this work, I beg all the pastors, this work must come from here. It must come from what? From here. Not in 419 ways. I beg everybody. Things will be tough at times, but you have to move on. The Lord will put you into test. You don't have to divert your ways. Continue. Because God wants to see your faithfulness. When you reach to your limit, the Lord will release blessings upon your life. Some people, they are using their own strength, deceiving members, lying to them, and doing some things. No member, no pastors, Gettysburg, Delaware, everywhere. I don't want anybody to do that. Work from your heart. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Even when men refuse to bless you, the one who have called you will make a way for you. Amen. I didn't hear amen. Amen. I didn't hear amen. Amen. Church, number two, when the favor of God comes upon your life, you will stop saying thank you to people and people will begin to say thank you to you. Amen. This 2017, I want you to put this into your agendas, your plans, that people must say thank you. Amen. To what? To you. You have been saying thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Enough is enough. Are they? Why? Thank you, Mr. J. May the good Lord bless you. You have been blessing people, but people can't bless you. Why? You take it and put it in your pocket. Take it and put it. Let it go. Everybody shout hallelujah. Let me tell you this. When you even let them go, God can stand on it and bless you with children. Whereby you will not pray for. Maybe
You are married, you have your husband. It has been so many years, 10 to 11 years, 12 years. No child. Start giving. You don't need a prophetic word. And when God wants to bless your children, will not give you troublesome one. The gift of God is perfect. If you don't know, it's perfect.
Anje, God bless you. God bless you. You told them. Oh, God bless you, Angie. Clap your hands for Angie.
Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, start doing it. And you will see what the Lord will do in your life. Church, before I proceed, listen to me very well. The world doesn't want you to give. But they use their money and sponsor nasty things. Somebody can send million and say that they should fight against this. Am I right? Which it doesn't implant with the word of God. Like gay and those things. Somebody can send $10 million and say that they should do this. But how much more about the work of God? So if the world, you know, worldly people, if they want to give, people will not talk. But as a Christian, when you give, people will talk. You go to church, you give. All these pastors this day. All these pastors this day. 419. Yes, I will tell you the truth. We have 419 ones. If you don't take it, they will dupe you good. But I am here to assure you that go home and pray. I am not like them. Let me tell this. I am too high. And to do that, may the Lord forbid. I will even feel shy to dupe somebody. I will not bring myself down. If you do something here, or you sow something here, or put something here, it goes with the word, the work of God. It's for the what? The work of God. Shout hallelujah. It's for the what? The work of God. Everybody shout amen. Everybody shout glory be to God. All the glory and honor be unto him. Father, receive your praise. Look unto your neighbor and say, because of the favor. Look unto someone and say, because of the favor. Your life will never be the same. Everybody shout hallelujah. When the favor comes upon your life. I went to Africa and there was a time last year. A certain honorable guy recently called me about 3 days ago. And when Pastor Vivian went home, the guy went to our place and, you know, say hi unto them. Madam, how are you doing? The man came, Prophet, if you are here in Ghana, Prophet, we will make money. I said, Honorable, what is good? I said, you have to come from America. Come, Prophet, I have a concession, a land is full of gold. Someone in Western, Wasa. Wasa Kropon is what? Western? Are you sure? Yes, Wasa Kropon. I have a concession, Prophet. I've given it to some people and I have 20 acres. Please, do you want it? I took some people that they tested it. Please, gold. I said, Honorable, you know I'm in America doing the work of words. Oh, my brother, you have to come. You'll make money. That is called favor. Came to my house begging me to come and take the land. But when I take it, how can I do? I am here.
I can't put one leg. I'm at one leg over there. Shout hallelujah. Somebody will say, oh, somebody will take care of that. When I put it into those things, I can't concentrate. Shout amen. Which if I'm somebody, all the our time, pack your things. Let's go and look for a school for their children over there. American school. They have American school in Ghana. Shout hallelujah. I will tell the members, oh, the Lord has spoke to me that I should go to Ghana for mission work. Wait for me 1 year. I'll go and chop some of the gold money and come back good. Shout amen. But I'm here preaching to you. Shout hallelujah. And when it is time for Pastor Sida, oh, we need a car. We have to buy a car for a prophet. You'll be giving $100 in the whole thing. Stop! It's an insult to me. Stop! If you don't want to give, don't give that 100. Everybody shout hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody? And I can buy it. From my pocket, I can do it more than 10 times. But the woman of God wants to do so that God will bless you. Shout hallelujah. She wanted to do so that God will what? Bless you. Somebody gave, Pastor Sidney came to me, somebody gave me 100. You told me. And I shot the book. I have it. Somebody gave this thing. Ah, with this kind of church, it's even a shame. We don't even have to mention it. Got some money and Kofi went over there. They said, ah, the car is high. And the money was less than 20,000 or 18 or something. And the car, good car, nice one. Am I right? Not Gugura Gugura one. So that your pastor can have more anointing and to preach to you. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I speaking to someone? Somebody, one person even can stand. And say that $40,000. What is $40,000? Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, it is time. Church, it's not, a joke. It's a serious thing. It's a serious what? It's a serious thing. Some people buy private jets. And just four wheels, start a car. Shout hallelujah. Whereby you are sitting on thousands, test God, prove him, and say that, Father, I am going to do. I have, Angie, you know, when I came here, glory be to God, I stayed with this, and I will continue to say it. That is me. When you do good to me, I will continue to say it. The time that my own people wanted to swallow me alive, they accepted me. Yeah. Shout hallelujah. They what? Stayed there over 5 years without paying a dime. There was a time we wanted to pay them something. And he said, oh, prof, what is going on? We don't need anything from you, please. When you do that, we'll be upset. We don't need anything. Full basement. Shout hallelujah. People used to come there. You and Amy and their mother, they used to come to that place. And Pastor Sida, yeah. Pastor Chris saw Pastor Sida and said, let's go and see a certain man of God. Came to my basement. And Pastor Sida now is a pastor here. So do you know the reason? It means that that basement has saved so many people. Shout hallelujah. My living room and my bedroom. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. And at that time, T-boy, TGN, oh God. Little ones. Wake up one morning, Chichi used not less than 13 eggs by my door. I opened the door, started running. I said, Chichi, come here. He said, hey, Witcher, let's go. They started running. I said, look at you. And look at them now. Shout hallelujah. Church, listen to me. Listen to me. When the favor of God comes up, church, may God forbid that for you to impose on someone and say that do this, you will never get me. Far be from me. But I am teaching you and giving you a word that can release favor upon your life. Shout hallelujah. A certain man that I sat under, my leader, was a Bible teacher. I served him for 12 to 13 years. I went through so many things. Mr. Joe and the pioneers in this ministry, they know that man. One time came to this place, so many things, you know, happened. And my wife too went through so many things. Church, which I can say that at this time, when the man even call, you have to say that I am busy. Am I right? But because of the fear of God and God himself, you have to open up. Does it make sense? Does it make sense? And I have this in mind. That one day, I will sit down with my wife and we will think about something and I will build a house for him. Yeah. Shout hallelujah. And say that because of what you did. 13 years, I went through insult, so many things. It wasn't easy. Shout amen. I was under him as an assistant pastor, a prophet, and he was a teacher. Saw my wonderful wife, Pastor Vivian, you know, I love you. Do you love me? At that time, I was too dark. You know, do you love me? And my wife too said, if you love me, me too, I love you. Shout hallelujah. I know that you have a powerful future. If you love me, I love you. Love me, I love you. Love me, I love you. And now we love ourselves. Shout hallelujah. Shout amen. And my wife, you know, my pastor told my wife that you must come and let me take you through some counseling. You know, let me counsel you and some things. My wife went there and, Vivian, do you love Dwomoh? He said, yes, of course. He said, do you love Dwomoh? He said, yes, of course. He said, Dwomoh doesn't have a future. Why do you have to marry Dwomoh? I have somebody for you, a good guy, that can take care of you. I didn't have a dad. But my wife said, whether Pastor Frank has it or not, Pastor Alok, come and see insult. Come and see insult. Started insulting this one, my wife. He said, I have somebody for, not knowing that, wanted to take her, give her to somebody. And now, you know, there was a time that person, I won't mention it. Shout hallelujah. The one that my pastor wanted to what? Give my wife to. I am the one that at times I can give him something. Amen. He can come to our place. My wife will cook and will eat. I say, take this. If it wasn't the word called determination and somebody who has foresight, the pastor could have her destiny. Never allow anybody, Paulette, to divert your destiny. Let me tell you, when you have foresight, I didn't have anything, but because of the foresight. Suppose if my wife followed those things and, you know, went with, that man, somebody right now, am I right? Will be enjoying. Am I right? But because of the foresight. You must have a foresight. A man can come to you today with common slippage, but you have to bind into the future. A man can come to you today without any watch. Do not insult him. Bind into the future. Maybe that man one day. So my wife came to me and said, leave the church. Look at this. I went to come and see insult. But I said, so what did you say to him? He said, I told him that I love you. And he started in shock. I said, do you want to go? He said, do I have to go where? I have nowhere to go. Shout hallelujah. But upon the things that he did and those things, church, I still have something in mind. It won't be long. It won't be long. And I've already, you know, put his land somewhere for him. I will build a house for him. Everybody shout hallelujah. And call him, because he has been going through so many things, suffering and going through something. I will call him one day and say, come, let me show you something. This is your key. Everybody shout hallelujah. Church, never joke with a man or a woman who has been favored. Shout hallelujah. Favor is very important. Favor is what? Very important. Some woman who wants to see somebody already made and enjoy from day one. At times, God can do it. I'm telling you, God can do it. God can give you somebody who is rich. You have to accept it. But at times, you can start with someone. So whichever way, if it is the will of God, you have to accept it. Everybody shout hallelujah. You have to what? Accept it. Pastor Vivian went home and his children, you know, went over there, blessed them, gave them something, told their dad and their mom. Say that, mama, they started saying so many, mama, ooh. The woman called Pastor Vivian and said, God bless you with that big money. He said, yeah, mama, they deserve it. He said, you and Pastor Frank, you deserve that blessing. My son told me about everything. I said, that is the doing of God. Let them see it with their eyes and go out there and say it. Do not say it yourself. When the favor comes upon your life, may this word, church, change your entire life. Shout hallelujah. Shout amen. Shout hallelujah. Do you know that when you give something to God, that is big, that will touch the heart of God, when God begins to do something in your life, church, it will turn into tears of joy. I know it and I have seen it. And I am a witness to that. Everybody shout hallelujah. The last thing. Verse what? Verse 12, am I right? Moses said to the Lord, you have been telling me, lead these people. You have been telling me, lead what? These people. But you have not let me know whom. Whom? You will what? Send with me. Look at this man. You have said that I know you by name. And you have found what? You have found what? You have found what? You have found favor with me. If you are pleased with me, teach me your ways so that I may know you and continue to find favor with you. Church, you have to protect favor. If you have what? Release me. And if you have called me, please teach me your ways so that I will continue to find favor. You can mess up with favor if you don't take care. Favor is something that when it comes upon you, you don't have to fool. You don't have to behave just anyhow. You have to be sober. You have to be what? Vigilant, church, and continue to hold it like what? Like something special. Do not let anybody take it from your hands. Because of favor, Somebody can be number one. You can be number 11. Eh? That person will pass all of them, 1 up to 10, and come to you, number what? 11. Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that? It happened in the word of God. Jacob has how many children? 12 powerful children. Am I right? Which, let me use 13. One was called Dinah. Shout amen. Yes, Jacob had 13. One was called Dinah, but you know, those days they didn't, you know, used to mention the name. Yeah, Dinah was raped. They raped Dinah, if you know. But 12, let me use 12. And in Israel, according to their custom, number 11 is taboo. Number 11, they don't believe it. That is why when Judas sinned against God, they have to replace somebody. Matthias. And to become what? 12. They don't believe number 11. They believe that it's a bad luck or something, you know, according to your custom. But when God wanted to do something in the life of Jacob's children, God passed by the number one, number two, number three, and the Lord lifted the 11 that represent a man called Joseph. So do you know the reason why God didn't take the number three or number seven? Somebody could have said that completion or perfection. But the Lord said that I would take that taboo number. The one that you guys don't believe, you don't have faith in, you don't have any hope. The one that the people, they have rejected. And we all know that there was no marriage arrangement between Joseph's mother, am I right? And Jacob. Benjamin and Joseph was from the same and the same father. Am I speaking to somebody? But the Lord said that I would take the one that they have rejected, number 11, and I will polish that one and use that one, you know, for the sake of my own name. And the Lord lifted that man called Joseph. Everybody shout hallelujah. When God picked that man called Joseph, number 11, the taboo number, do you know the reason why? Because Joseph found favor in the sight of God. And the word of the Lord said that because his father loved him, his father gave him a coat of many colors. Does it make sense? And his own brothers wanted to kill him. But the Lord said it will never happen. I will protect him for the sake of my name. Church, if you have found favor, whether you like it or not, before God, people will jealous you. That is why I said it earlier on that the junior brother to what? Favor is called what? Jealousy. They wanted to kill that guy. But God secured that young boy. Because of the favor of God, people will hate you. They will talk about you. They will gossip. They will try to pull you down. But let me tell you this. The favor will fight itself. That favor alone can fight itself. You don't have to give up. May the good Lord lift you up and take you onto the higher realms. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Everybody shout glory be to God. Let's go to the book of Psalm 5 and verse 12. And I will be done for today. The book of Psalm 5 and verse number what? Who has the NIV Bible, please? Psalm 5 and verse number what? NIV. Yeah. As I read. Listen to me. Surely, Lord, you bless righteous. Are you a righteous person?
You surround them with your favor.
Ah, look at this. Oh, look at it. You surround them with your what? And what?
As with a what?
A shield.
Because you fear God, may the good Lord today surround you with favor.
Church, what is the meaning of that? What is the meaning of that? It means that favor from today going, it is going to be your fence, your wall. Shout hallelujah. When you build a house, you have to put a what? You have to put a what? So somebody who feared the Lord, favor is your what? 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 May the good Lord, starting from today, take you onto the higher dimension. May your life never be the same. In Jesus' name with thanksgiving, shout hallelujah. Say, Lord, give me favor. Say, Father, give me favor. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Let me tell you this. Do you know that God himself gave Jesus favor? He said, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, drew it in what? In what? Number one, stature. Number two, wisdom. Number three, the word of the Lord said, and he found favor in the sight of men. You need favor. If God gave Jesus favor, how much more about you? You need the favor of God. And listen to me. Favor of God is something that when you pray, church, do not forget. You have to place your hand, your right hand upon your head and say, the Lord, give me your favor. I need your favor. You have to ask. You have to seek. Even if you want to fast, fast for the favor. Spend 3 hours for the favor. And when that favor comes upon your life, something that has to take somebody 11 years to do, you will use 1 year. May the favor of God take you onto the higher dimension. May your life never be the same. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. May you clap your hands for Jesus.